tents were put up and the pints of Guinness went down. Musicians have come from afar to the beat of the drums and the wail of electric guitars. This ain't a show for dogs or for cats. This ain't a show for the rats. This ain't a field where cows get to eat. This is a party, party for sheep.
Three great things about sheep music.
Or four.
Or four. Or two. About one.
Mm-hmm.
A favourite moment then?
A favourite moment would be easy. Very
good. Jalikunda or whatever they're called.
The one memorable moment from the festival for me was Friday night. I was really fucked and I can't remember like where I went.
So it wasn't
but
that
no,
memorable
no, that's
then.
Not true.
No. I remember being fucked, and this isn't going to make it into the video because I've seen your editing, so I'm alright.
I've remembered my festival highlight. It was the power cut on Sunday night when generator number one failed and the site lights and everything else on the site went. About six times, and you could hear the generator go boom, boom, and then Sheriff fixed it within a minute. It was very impressive.
Moment of the weekend when I realised it was going to all be alright.
Favourite moment of the festival is probably the moment you're going to turn that camera off.
The most special. I don't know if I should talk about that, really.
Woo!
Who knows?
Special moment for Gabriel. Gabriel got laid.
Was it your first time?
The toilet guys, because I've been supporting them over the years, they decided to dedicate a toilet, a cubicle, especially for me.
And I'd like to thank all of you who put the festival together, because this year's been fucking brilliant. Especially the girls in the toilets, to clean them up. I came out my tent yesterday, it was, and there's a woman walking to me wearing rubber gloves and a flagon, and I thought, that's my ideal woman, the things we could do.
There's a little sort of sign on the wall saying this laboratory is dedicated to dirty light, etc. And I was going to have my picture taken on it and hopefully sort of squeeze into the brochure next year or something, but unfortunately we went to do the picture this morning and someone's stolen it for a souvenir, so that's out.
Well, I wasn't particularly impressed, to be honest. I was humiliated enough by selling it publicly on video, but then to broadcast it over the main tent on the final band of this festival was, I think, taking the piss a bit, so I'm going to have a serious word with the people responsible and there could be some bloodshed.
I mean, I think there's definitely a legal angle you could pursue there.
Mm. I think so.
My favourite moment was cutting my hands. My favourite moment of the whole weekend was Sean's hair.
I'm just getting all my microphones back just now. I thought they'd been stolen, but in fact they were in a box.
Last night was fun. To drag myself into action,
cause I'm so tired of struggling. Favourite moment.
Probably Saturday. No, I haven't got a favourite moment. It was all fun.
A performance by the miniature Elvises. Half a dozen dwarves in Elvis jumpsuits doing a trapeze act from the ring from the tent. And it was just the weirdest thing. Thing. Yeah, it's just like.
I think you can say that now.
Youngsters and everybody can go at it, you know, so it's really, I really cool. Enjoy it.
One sentence.
No, I can't do this.
too much out. They get given too much in to start with. People give them money, and nobody ever knows where the money that they make goes to.
And so, they end up at Glastonbury.
Why do you think it's growing so much?
Because the pop it's so popular. With all the music and that, and everything that's going on there. Because there's a lot going on there, isn't there?
Well, then why do they need all the money that they have? I mean, the council gives them money, Powys gives them money.
Do you think it's good? Does it bring in business from town anyway?
Not a lot.
Do you think so?
Not a lot.
It is very good for the town, yes. Business-wise, it is anyway.
I find it, the atmosphere is good, the people always seem happy there,
yeah.
The music is good, you just can't fault it.
It's special.
A little festival, that's special.
What do you think of sheet music? What does it represent to you?
The good time. Really interesting music festival with extraordinarily diverse, eclectic mix of bands from all over the world. Very friendly, you know, smallish kind of rock music festival.
The other thing I wanted to say was please just pick up your litter as you're building. You can do that.
Boom! Feet quick, picking it up to hit the top, making a move, delicious groove, touching every one of you. Busy brain, taking it to the make a change, giving it to the needs of break, making a stage for us to play. Sing, drum, giving it to the needs of groove, body, mind, and soul will move, making a stage for us to groove. Sing, drum, giving it to the needs of groove, body, mind, and soul will do. Sing, drum, play away.
Coming, I'm coming. Coming, I'm coming.
Shalom, one love, peace and love. Yeah, oh, me,
thinking about how hard it is to make anything, and I'm thinking about pieces of 2x1 wood, tape measures, swords. Where do you find the swords? Who's got all the swords? Who's got all the cordless drills? Where are the drill bits? Who's got the screws?
Apparently I'm a hard man to work for.
Who's going to help? Where are the swords? Where's the 2x2? Where are the drills? Who's got the wood?
I don't want to be interviewed right now. So here they come, rolling out of the pub at 12:30.
Yeah.
Off up to the site for a couple of takeouts. Nice early 8 a.m. start.
Yeah.
He's off, I tell you.
Yeah. Didn't think he's been up since like 8.
What time
did you get on site?
10. What time is it now?
It's 1:25.
No.
Yeah.
Pete Smith's got us on site at 8.
What time does it start?
First programme band, I think, is 6 o'clock.
Because we went to the art close together. She turned up a minute.
Gareth?
Really wicked.
Can you work out a way we can keep that on the floor?
Are we just on your first year?
Yeah.
Because look at the lovely shadows we get off there.
Yeah.
I'm here because I love it. You will see my dog sniff my ass again.
Oh, 50? 50 rashes of bacon and 50 fried eggs, 50 buttered buns. I see all the tents are up there sort of thing, you know, and it looks like it should be a good show. Might have a walk up there and have a look, see if they're giving anything.
This week, this thing up here, this ambient tent.
The ambient tent. So why have you got involved with shooting yourself?
Involved? Well, it's a community thing which was started by my mum and my stepdad, so I saw them doing it, so when I got to the age where I felt responsible enough, I joined in.
Are you glad you did?
Yeah, definitely, it's been wicked, it's been good fun.
How are things going?
I think they're going fine. Everywhere looks incredibly well organised and incredibly calm.
And how many stewards do you have this year? Under your thumb?
I have 30 on the gates, and there are 65, I think, general stewards. So that's nearly 100 stewards. Which is a lot, isn't it? Does that make me very, very important?
Our job is cleaning toilets.
And general side
meetings. And general, anything disgusting that needs doing, we do it.
You're the girls for the job.
Yeah, it's horrible. Sick, poo, anything, we clean it up.
I'm sewing together 2 bed sheets from Tuffins to make the other screen in the main stage for the visuals.
There's lots of disgusting toilets. I think the worst thing was when a guy passed out in one the other year with his trousers around his ankles, and we had took 3 of us to get him out of there. Not joking, shouting at him to wake up. That was not funny. That was quite scary actually. We thought he died.
How many signs have you made, Julie?
Exactly 763.
How many of those did you drill?
Well, that's 4 holes, so that's 763 times 4. That's exactly 972.
Yeah. Getting excited now?
Yeah. Really sort of, yeah.
The sun's come out as well, which is nice.
Yeah. How long have you been doing it? How many years?
Oh, not many. 3, 4, 5.
Did you get paid?
No.
Why'd you do it then?
Oh, just for the love of it, you know, the ethos, the kudos, there's all sorts of things.
What's so great about sheet music then?
The atmosphere, definitely. Very communally based.
2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Islands in the stream, that is what we are. Have you got miniatures on? Mm-hmm.
Basically what we do is play music, make people dance, have lots of fun.
Yeah, some of the best gigs we've done have been in fields. Smeren is the name of a village in Russia, isn't it?
My name is Humphrey and I play the dub siren and other various instruments. And I'm the leader of the band.
My name's Tom, I play a horn. I also lead the band.
I think this interview needs more structure, quite frankly.
Well, where is it? Your family came from there, didn't they? Well, it's his surname. They were mad for it. I think everyone was mad for it.
Yeah. Well, I'm the leader of the band and my name's George and I play the guitar.
you're exposing gaps in my knowledge of sheep.
I'm Nick. I'm the real leader of the band. This is going to be awful, isn't it?
It's just better and better this year. It's a little bit bigger, but then more people and the site's bigger to cope with it, so it's absolutely perfect. And the vibe is just even better because there's more people spreading that, everyone's chilled out.
All the time I worked here, I never knew that there was a back door. So I walk over and I stare at it.
Stare at it!
And I could swear it had never been there before, but
never.
There it is. So I turn the handle off. I don't know where it's going to come out, and I found myself in the Sheep Music Festival.
How many Sheep Musics have you been to now so far?
I've been to all 483. The first one, if I remember rightly, would have been held in about 1592.
1592?
Yes, it was a slightly smaller site. And Mustel, of course, was booking the bands still in those days. And so we had someone, we had the Green Sleeves Trio, they're marvellous. Happy days. Happy days.
Here's a song you're confessing up.
couple of questions, okay?
Yeah, great. Why, your timing's fantastic.
Why do you come to shoot music?
Because we've been coming to shoot music for quite a long time and it's fun.
Yeah. Right, okay, what do you do when you're not at shoot music then?
Hang around on street corners.
You feed your children.
Well, we do wood carvings, and I help Harry sometimes if I've got time. Other than that, I look after the family.
How many kids do you have?
Dream of having great catering businesses. Harry and I got 8 children. I said my children between us.
Who else me? I'm not Harry.
I think it's 8.
Hey, who's your friend then? Is that Jetty, yeah? Okay, Mum.
Finding her in here every morning, chopping things. This is Andrea, and she is one of my best friends.
How many best friends do you have?
Not many.
Who are these girls then, Mum?
Well, this is Esme here. This is Esme. And he just walked across the camp there. It's Thursday.
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 Thursday. Yeah. Ooh, this all looks really nice.
It's pretty, isn't it? Okay. Look, you could film the coleslaw as well.
Very nice.
We're going to be playing at 8 o'clock. Is he done in the band?
So yes, we are fun-loving people.
www.isidan.com.
They were fantastic, they were just wonderful. I'm really quite choked up, really enjoyed myself, it's been fantastic.
Bring you down or make you feel bad, I'm just horsing around. Indulging in some hijinks, it's all about timing. You wanna take me seriously? It's been said I can't take my own medicine. I'm reticent to hell with them, I mean, had it back again. Crack a knock with the Pope in a nunnery, so come poke fun at me. Step up, take a pop at me. There really no stopping me. Everybody plan me. Wind it up.
time.
Wind it up. 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 Wind it up.
Thank you very much, lady.
It went fine. I just, that little bit at the end where I try and sing really high, but I knew that my throat wasn't going to do it. And we've got 3 more gigs this weekend, so I grabbed myself by my nuts and twisted them really hard and hoped that would like sort my voice out, but it hasn't. I've just really fucking hurt myself.
It was good.
How was the audience?
They were great. I like it when there's kids in the audience. You don't really get in the clubs that we play at.
Shackled by the wrist, handcuffed, no. Adhesive, glue, used divining rod, is douse.
Get all loved up in the ambient tent in a bit, so if you want to come and have a cuddle.
Would you like to tell us what happened in the early hours of Saturday morning?
Well, I was walking home with my friends John and Angela, having had a great night at sheet music, and I was attacked by West Wall, and it leapt out and broke my arm.
And that's the truth.
That and me practicing my ministry of silly walks and trying to emulate my favourite person, John Cleese.
So, it is true then that you were dancing in the streets?
Weren't we all dancing in the streets after sheet music? I was just the unfortunate one. I don't think that the level of street lighting was the problem in this instance.
One final question, Mr. Kirkby. How much exactly had you had to drink on the night in question?
No comment.
What are you doing here this year at sheet music?
We're selling our teepees.
Cool.
Yeah, we make them and sell them.
How?
In Hereford, so... Hoping somebody might want to pop in and have a cup of tea with us.
Yeah.
Have a look at it.
Have you been to sheet music before?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You bet. We love it. No, we come back every year.
What's the best thing about it?
We're not to sell teepees. It's the first time.
I really
bought a teepee, so. Yeah.
Good luck.
Yeah, thanks very much.
Well, the music's the best thing about it because you always have great bands and unusual bands from all over the place. And,
yeah.
And the vibration is very nice.
Good atmosphere.
Lovely.
So lovely to be here.
Lovely
people.
So
we thank
everybody
going.
Who puts
everybody's
it on.
Everybody's really helpful.
Yeah.
Really
nice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We have to go to work in like 10 minutes.
You reckon tonight?
5 minutes.
What are you doing?
4 hours of parking.
Me too.
Parking.
Well done.
Are you all on the same shift?
Yeah.
Are you actually going to do any work?
No.
You good? You enjoying sheet music?
Yes.
Yay. Yay.
Music's always brilliant and you don't get it in today's pop culture.
It appears to be very relaxed and friendly.
It's
really awesome. Mad, crazy.
The stewarding's going fine.
I think most of my students are sober. The only thing that's amazed us is how attached to their cars hippies are. We need a massive sign in the car park saying, "You're a bloody hippie, get out your car and walk."
How are you feeling?
I'm good. I've had...
What were you just about to say then, though, that you said I can't say that?
Well, it was offensive, I might say.
Go on, say it.
I've had 2 abs of Strongbow, and I think I'd be anyone's. I'm feeling quite lightheaded after my...
I'm a bit drunk.
And is this just the Guinness? Yeah. Cheap dates, there you go. Come over, Harry. It's in my place.
So, Harry, you're from London.
Yep.
And why did you come to sheet music?
Well, my mum and dad split up, and I'm living with my mum at the moment. She's a festival freak, basically. She goes to all the festivals ever.
Right.
And she took me to this one. I've been to this one loads of times, and I really, really liked it. And I just wanted to come here again, basically.
Wicked.
Probably try and run away.
Eat.
Sit down. I'm doing nothing. They do.
Just like sit around and sleep all day.
This is church, everybody.
Sweet music. Right, we have got the Rumba Love Train on the main stage shortly. So get yourself a coffee. Sounds good, doesn't it? Rumba Love. It's going to be good, isn't it? You can feel it. So, yeah, that's going to be on the main stage next. And that'll be on shortly. So get yourself a coffee, sort yourself out, and then go over there, and we'll see you over there. All right, take care.
I said, I'm just getting a Guinness, and then I'll sit down there, and then you can interview me at your leisure.
I am. This year, I'm singing with the Gravy Train Orchestra at 6 o'clock in the main arena, which is an examination of Britain's railway systems.
Nice.
Written by Pete Mustard.
And it's going to last an hour, is it now?
It's going to seem like longer.
I'm Pete.
Okay, Pete, what's this Love Train thingy all about?
But it was an idea to do a kind of... For the last 2 years we've been doing a youth band at Sheet Music, which is called, which we do various things. But mostly playing covers of other people's tunes.
Right.
And this year, John Hymer's here. John and I thought we'd write something that could include the youth band and also include a few of the local stars. Oh, yeah. Get on board. band, he used to always sing "People Get Ready, There's a Train Coming." That was one of his songs, you know. So he was an obvious choice.
Yeah.
And I'm doing a song, and Dirty Ray's doing a couple of songs,
Do
and
we
the Polysumi sisters, and there are pictures of drains.
In here?
No.
Bit of a sting?
No. Because
no.
We haven't rehearsed it.
Oh, okay. So, not even a sample, two lines.
We ran through it this morning on an accordion.
How did you do it all together?
About 25, 28.
And the massive fusion of 21 musicians in the rumba train thing. Yeah. And that's what it's about, getting different things together, you know, hey, let's do this. We don't have to be a band that's, you know, blah, blah, blah. We're just here, we're going to do it. That's the beauty of festivals.
How many musicians are we going to do? 21 musicians.
Here come the Rumble Jacks. Unless a man might use this slight lull in the proceedings, if he had written a best-selling book on the topic of trains, to use this opportunity to plug that book, Parallel Lines by Ian Marchant.
Guardian, a little classic, The Guardian.
What, is it a little book?
No, it's quite a big book.
But they meant...
It's a little classic.
Which you can buy at good station bookstores, you see?
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you. it's great, yeah, I think it went really well. Yeah. And Sam Ben did a good job as well. It's pretty tough, really.
That was really good. That was wicked.
But Parallel Lines, my lovely train book, a little classic, The Guardian.
Yeah. A little classic.
Parallel Lines. That was out in mass market paperback last week.
Right.
And ideal Christmas gift, really, to be honest with you.
I'm considering it for my father.
It's yes. Yes, and that's been my career, really.
Right.
I write books that people buy for their dads. But
and for us, actually,
yes.
To be fair. They're fairly for everyone.
They are for everyone, yes.
Good.
Not probably your mum, though.
Not my mum?
Probably not. No.
Why? Do you mean not women as a whole?
No, women, but probably not your mum. No.
Yeah. Are they rude?
They are a bit.
Are they?
My mum said to me, my first book, I said, and I know my mum had never read a book before, and she hadn't, you know, it's all right. So she read this book. I said, what do you think? She says, it's full of words. I say, it's a book, mother. She says, you know what I mean, young man.
Oh, words.
Words, yeah. Right. And I said a word last night and on stage, but it was 11 o'clock at night, and this very tall hippie bloke, but young, like 22, but taller than me, came up and he said, I don't think you should swear in front of little children, yeah?
Oh dear.
And I'm just about to say, fuck off, when... when they turned my mic off. It was so depressing.
We're so happy.
Well, so I'm having a wonderful time. I'm really sorry about the rain.
It's the smallest hour, persuaded not to turn to day and stay dark just for us. The day is dangerous. No, I'll have to put up a fight if you kiss me in broad daylight. But tomorrow's another night. No.
Thank you.
So Will, are you enjoying sheet music? Me, Missy. Me, Missy.
Oh, my leg. Oh, my arm. Enemy Lanaza, Godness, that's it, that's it.
Come on, here we go.
Enemy Lanaza, Raisa, Sinsenabu. Musica shipping, then I saw musica ship music.
Come on, here we go, one of the best sound.
I'd also like to say I'm celebrating 30 years of festivals this year, from 74 to 204.
Hooray!
And Windsor 74 was my first festival, and obviously age minus six, but hey, you know, I was there. No, it's, and it really is, this just sums up the best things, what it's all about, you know, the fact that we can come together, old, young, fat, thin, crazy, insane, off the, everything, everybody together and have a beautiful time. You know, and that's what you created, and I just feel so privileged to be here. It's really great.
Okay. It's time to throw away your doubt, or throw away your blues. Wake up in the morning and tear up the news. Go on and slap yourself, it's been too long. Put on that Motown record, stop thinking you're wrong, 'cause you keep worrying about yourself. You keep worrying about yourself. It leads to nowhere else if you keep worrying about yourself. Here at Sheep Music, everybody should sing good music, 'cause those that abuse it are bound to lose it. In a field with John Lowe. And is your brain all angry when you wake up to inner city sounds and Palestine news? Whether you're really in love, whether she loves you too, whether you're meant to be doing just what you do, that you keep worrying about yourself. Oh, you keep worrying about yourself. It leads to nowhere else if you keep worrying about yourself. I'm so tired, so staying, so tired today. I'm so tired, always so worry. Whoa, whoa, yeah, you keep worrying about yourself. You keep worrying about yourself. It leads to nowhere else if you keep worrying, worrying, worrying.
Whoa. This is our first band. They're called Nizlopi, I believe. And they'd probably like to tell you why they're called Nizlopi.
We're called Nizlopi. We're called Nizlopi because there was a beautiful Hungarian girl called Nina Nizlopi, and she was around us when we were younger.
So you've known each other for a while then?
Yeah, when we were 14, and And our band got named Nizlopi when we were 14, yeah.
Okay. Are you married?
No.
Are you married?
John is married, because he always calls Stephanie there his wife.
Influences, because we've had a few people saying Counting Crows, Matchbox 20, Dave Matthews Big Band. How do you feel about that?
John.
We get that a lot, actually, those two people, Counting Crows and Dave Matthews Big Band. And neither of us have heard Dave Matthews Big Band.
Well.
Our influences are, for Christ, everything, really.
It's going very well. We just need a rug. We caused major technical problems getting a rug.
What for?
Sorry?
What for?
For this mob up here. That's all.
Because as Herbert the Cosmic Parrot said at Watchfield 76, you just got to keep on keeping on.
Yeah, who's your favourite band?
Adrian Reflect.
Well, there was one back here last year who everybody was tripping at because he looked just like Jimi Hendrix.
I remember him, yeah.
Yeah, and he was wearing like trousers made out of curtains and everything. And the amazing thing was that when he started playing guitar,
I think it's more impressive having to find them rather than just being on like that. People were coming to him saying, like, here you go, you just have to say no. That would be amazing.
This is just
to go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Went to the Amelia tent, and I got rather wasted.
Yeah, baby!
Come on.
top stuff.
It says on my ticket, free otters.
There's no parents or teachers.
I've only got each other.
Extremely entertaining. We
are not a festival person.
Turn a blind eye, too scared to fight. Small town world is a small town mind. Think you got it bad, but don't come.
Can you come and dance with me? We were just going for a cup of tea.
Live from Sheep Music on Saturday night, we're now with Sergent Pepere. Could we please start with your names?
Take it easy, Stan. On trombone.
The fat Sapphire on the percussion.
Nestor, piss on you on the accordion.
Archie Extra Dry on the saxophone.
Rabbit the run from trombone.
Rhino the plumber on the sousaphone.
So you've just finished your set. How did it go?
Went okay with the audience, I think. Took me a while to get into it. It went okay.
So tell us, why Sergent Pepere?
Why not?
What we probably have to explain to English people is that, of course, it refers to the Beatles album, but when you pronounce it with a French accent, it gives Pepere.
What?
Oh, Daddy.
Relax.
Let's talk about your costumes. Did your mums make them?
No, we have a professional costume maker who made our costumes with a little costume maker's hands, and her name is Karine Delaunay, and we thank her very much.
Thank you, Karine.
There is also Stephen.
Thank you, Stephen, too. Let's talk about something more serious. What do you think about the British?
Very kind, but they're hard to understand. They speak too fast. But they're very welcoming. What do you think, boys? It's true. They are very nice.
And myths about Britain, like the weather and the food.
We ate really well. The sky is blue. The sky is blue and the food is good.
Pamika, cha 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 cha.
Thank you.
But also, Chaz and I, your dad,
right,
at some point tomorrow, we're doing a Bohemian Rhapsody workshop.
Oh, well, we must make sure we're around.
Because the British public keep voting for Bohemian Rhapsody. Isn't this right,
they
Harold?
Do.
They keep voting Bohemian Rhapsody as their favourite song of all time.
You can't go wrong with a bit of Queen.
We're hoping to cure the British people of this bit by bit. So we're going to, yeah, Bohemian Rhapsody workshop.
Chaz, yeah, he's got a point. Off with you. You're rubbish. Okay, it's Freddie Mercury. Anyway, Freddie Mercury's not even the guitarist. It's Brian May. And Chaz has hired his haircut for the weekend. What? Scaramouche, will you do the fandango? Freddie, of course, was a Zorro string, which is interesting that he's decided to use. But perhaps there are images kind of common across the Middle East. Yes, ma'am?
Is this Groundhog Day?
Yes. I see a little silhouette of a man. There's almost bound to be kind of a Scaramouche workshop somewhere. I think there's sort of clowns who wear humorous penis-shaped noses.
Is this Groundhog Day? He's just a poor boy
from a poor family, sparing his life from this monstrosity. I think I understand some of the lyrics.
Well, where are we going from? Can we check?
No, Chaz, we're not there yet. We're not getting... Yes. Let him go, Bismillah. He's being executed. That's, you know, Mama just killed a man, you know, I don't want to die. And he's having some sort of, I don't know, he's in death row, having some sort of hideous vision of some kind. And a chorus of devils or something, or angels, are saying, spare him his life from this. This is to say the execution. Monstrosity.
When are you going to finish?
Never. You've all died. You're in hell.
Because cockles, they're really slimy.
Oh, yeah. They come in liquid, don't they?
Yes. Mm. It's like swallowing... It's like swallowing an oyster. Have you ever swallowed an oyster, Lucy?
Whiz. I haven't.
Have you ever felt...
I haven't, actually.
A globule slip down what?
You know how apparently oysters are...
Yes.
Like sex, they're aphrodisiac.
Yes.
Yeah? I heard the other day that apparently it's not the taste at all, it's the actual, because they look like a labia or whatever. Oh. No, is that there?
No.
So sexual.
I don't
it's
know.
Sexual.
It's been some time since I've seen
an
oyster, so.
Is sheet music everything you hoped it would be then?
It's great, it's gone really fast. But.
Where's the best tent? Pardon? Where's the best tent? Obviously, Alan. The ambient and the...
White lightning, Alan!
Alan!
But, yeah, the decor in there is great, I heard.
You decorated, didn't you?
Yeah, me and Megs did. Well, not just us, obviously, but...
You're going to be helping with the clear-up?
Sorry?
You're going to be helping with the clear-up?
Clear-up? Well, if I'm around...
I'm looking forward to dancing after I finish the studio.
Yeah.
I'm Clive with the Festival Medical Services. I'm a first aider. Jan's a first aider as well.
These two are first aiders.
Yeah.
Yep. This is what you do when we finish work.
Just before you start.
This
work.
Is, yeah.
Yeah. Come back in half hour, you see what we do after work.
Yeah, Chris and Anne Howes, we're involved in a group in an organisation called Festival Medical Services, and we provide cover for events like this and other events around the country. We did this event last year and really enjoyed it, so we were very pleased to be asked back again this year, and so far it's gone very well. It's been very quiet, hasn't been anything terribly serious, and most of it's been kind of very minor stuff which we've been able to deal with quite easily, so we're very happy with the way it's gone, aren't we?
Very happy, yes. It was this long.
And the actions?
Defeated. It was the look on Gareth's face when we told him what we've actually been doing for the past 2 days. He's like, you've been pushing your hands down to the left.
No.
Very funny. We have to laugh about these things.
Yeah, lots of poo poking this year. Lots of sticks and poking turds to make sure.
Yeah.
It's really quite vulgar actually, we're having competitions, he's got the worst one.
Yes, Ellie's ahead of me on the vomit stakes, but I think the poo stakes I win actually. I think I'm ahead on poo.
I get the award for most variety of disgusting things dealt with actually using this time. It's a really rank shit in the...
Anyway, shit job, but someone's
going to
do it.
last year, someone handed in 50p to the lost property at Sheep Music. That won't happen anywhere else.
Did they claim it back? Only guitar, which was found.
Go behind the camera, me. Almost behind the camera. Get off. Oh dear, oh dear.
Don't forget to come and see the Your Dad show in the acoustics.
Oh, is it the shark?
Let's go! 1, 2, 3!
Well, basically, I come from a little planet called Nebula One, yeah? Just basically, we have a little spaceship. Well, the less said about our spaceship, the better.
Hi.
Hello.
She speaks very little English.
Uh-huh.
Are you really doing that?
We drank too much and we're feeling ill.
Oh no.
Yeah.
What's the cure for that?
Going home.
Try again.
Mayonnaise.
Oh no, there's plenty of people I want to say hello to. Every fuckhead out there, look. How are we?
Because the further you go back, the more mystic it gets, you know what I mean? Far out. Rock to the top, rocking with the top.
Yeah.
I should have said that there's no smoking anywhere on the train. This includes toilets. The word I was taught.
Long. When that long red train won't bring my baby back home. Ain't I right? Coming around that bend. Red train coming around that bend. Well, that dog, my baby. Won't be hard again. Hey, hey, hey. To the station every 4:44 and the station master said that train was running, running, moving, ain't train. Rolling down that track. They took my baby, we ain't never coming back. Ain't train coming down that line. Coming down that line. Bring my baby. Mine, oh mine.
À vendre, bien sûr.
Et demain, on joue à Shrewsbury.
That's Shrewsbury.
Shrewsbury.
Thank
you. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
See you next week. Next year. Week. Next year. Next year.